don't know.
No, it seems so long ago, Roger, doesn't it? I think it was a kind of perfect storm scenario in many respects. I'd worked with Marco Minimum in the Steve Wilson band, and prior to that I'd worked with Roger in the Hackett band. And the germ was having to learn guitar for the Hackett tours. Roger actually said to me, and I can still hear his words resonating in my ears, "What are you going to do with all your new guitar chops then?"
Did I say that?
Yeah, you did. It's exactly what you said to me.
It might have been ironic. Sarcastic.
Oh, you, well, everything you say is sarcastic, Roger.
Yeah, I suppose it is.
It is, isn't it? So, when Thomas Weber from Inside Out said to me, "You should be doing a project. Why are you not doing something? Playing with these great musicians, you should be doing something for yourself." I was surprised because I didn't think for one minute anyone would be really interested in anything I had to say. I know you're surprised that anyone is interested.
Oh, I'm pretty bored now.
Do you need some tranquilizers or maybe a pick?
No, this is working very well.
So, that was the essence of it. Looking around, thinking, who would I really work with in that situation? And despite the fact that he's always ripping me a new arsehole, he's great to work with. And also, Marco obviously is a great choice for a player because he brings something incredibly dynamic to a band. And I have a good relationship with him also. I think when I played him the demos for the first album, he also was very positive and responded in a very positive way.
Marco, we're talking about.
Yeah, unlike Roger, who tends to hang himself every time I send him a new song.
You had a rather different tack with me.
Yeah, I do have a different...
You took me on a romantic stroll on a Portuguese beach.
I did, it's true.
And seduced me into...
Made you all kinds of...
No other term for it. Seduced me into making this album.
Yeah.
That album.
Yeah. And because I still have the Polaroids, he can't say no.
Sorry, man.
How did we first meet? We were just talking about that.
We were just talking about I'm going to talk about it.
You should.
That's when Steve Hackett putting together a band to tour in 2008. Having just done Out of the Tunnel's Mouth and wanting to get this album at that time, wanted to get it out on the road. Yes, Nick's name had been looming large, the bass chair for some years, and in pursuit of a fresh bassist. Yeah, Nick's name came up, so we met in a pub in Twickenham called the Cabbage Patch.
I've got very fond memories of that.
I know, we were the Cabbage Patch Dolls, weren't we?
If only because as I walked in, you were already there. In, as we've already mentioned earlier today, your chunky knit off-white sweater. Very fetching thing with your chunky knit off-white hair.
Yeah.
Glenn, your then manager? Is
friend.
Friend.
Yes.
And protector.
Yes.
Leapt out of his chair as this ne'er-do-well approached you. Presumably to protect you against my...
And it was
my
you.
Advances.
Phew.
And we have looked back a lot since then.
Yes. That was the first time we met. On the first record, there are three drummers. Marco plays on most of the material. But also Gary O'Toole plays on a tune, and Nick DeVirginio plays on a tune. And I think that the whole thing about Marco was because I'd worked with him in the Wilson band. We had this relationship, a newer relationship, and we listened to each other's demos and we discussed them. And it seemed like we were kind of talking about a project without being aware of it. So when I finally decided to do something, Marco was, of course, the person I called. The other two guys also people I've worked with, and obviously Gary O'Toole works with us in the Hackett band, so I had to have him involved as well.
reaction was unbelievable, to be honest. And the thing that surprised me most was, because my day job is touring at Hackett, or working at Hackett, the number of people who approached me at gigs while I was out on the road with him, saying, "Oh, I really like the new Gods album." Oh my, you know, people bought the bloody thing.
They did buy it.
And volunteered these comments. The reaction was absolutely stunning. And yes, of course, we are award winners. And there won't be any more.
I disagree.
No, I don't mean that. I mean from that source.
Well, you know, the thing is, I love to see the smile on his little punim when we get the accolades.
Sod off.